Is your edit feeling clunky or awkward? Transitions could be the solution. Transitions provide a seamless connection between clips, giving your video a smooth flow without abrupt scene changes. When used effectively, they can enhance the visual quality of your videos and improve storytelling. In this video, I'll explain how to add and customize transitions in Premiere Pro so that you can choose the perfect ones for your projects. Before you add transitions, it's important to arrange your footage properly. Transitions work best when your edit is locked in place, so you should apply them at the final stages of your edit. Once your clips are arranged, open the Effects panel. If you don't see it, you can go to Window, Effects. Then, expand the Video Transitions folder. Here, you'll see a variety of transition types, including 3D motion, dissolve, wipes, and zooms. From smooth fades to animated page peel transitions, Premiere Pro has a variety of basic options to choose from. Above the Video Transitions folder, you'll also see an Audio Transitions folder. These effects help smooth out sound changes, making transitions even more seamless. You can apply them like video transitions to fade out music or blend dialogue between clips. To learn more about audio transitions, check out our previous tutorial by clicking the link above or in the description down below. We recommend playing around with these transitions to see which ones fit best for your project. Now, let's add a video transition to your edit. Once you find the transition you like in the effects panel, drag and drop it onto the cut line between two clips in your timeline. A tan transition box will then appear between the clips. You can test different transitions by dragging and replacing them. Once you hit play, you'll see the transition between these two clips take place. To remove one, select the transition box and press delete. When you're editing with video transitions, there's an important point that you should keep in mind. Even though you apply the transition at the end and start of two clips, Premiere Pro uses the video information beyond the cut point to execute the transition. This means that you should make sure that the clip has enough remaining length and doesn't have any issues like camera shake. Otherwise, that will bleed through into this transition. If your clip doesn't have enough length for the transition to be completed, Premiere will let you know with this error message. If you want to apply the same transition to multiple clips, right-click your transition and select Set Selected as Default Transition. Select all of the clips you want to apply it to and then press Ctrl-D or Command-D if you're on a Mac to apply the transition across your selection. Once the transition is applied, you can adjust it in several ways. For example, you can adjust the transition length to match your video's pacing by selecting the transition box in the timeline, then dragging the edges outward to make the transition longer, or inward to shorten it. If you need more precise control, you can also manually adjust the transition duration in the effects controls panel. For example, if you click the transition here in the effects controls, you can now see a mini timeline that displays where the transition is positioned. You can then drag it to decrease or increase the transition length. This approach is most effective if you have a busy or complicated timeline. If you want more control, you can also use keyframes to create custom transitions. For example, if you wanted to create a fade transition manually, select the clip you want to fade, then open the effects controls panel. From here, find the opacity property and add keyframes at the start and end of the transition. Finally, set the first keyframe's opacity to 100% and the final keyframe's opacity to 0%. This technique works for custom zooms, slides, and opacity changes. Instead of using a preset effect, you'll have full control over the transition speed and style. While Premiere Pro offers a range of basic transitions, the Storyblocks library offers more advanced options to elevate your production or video project. Adding them to Premiere Pro couldn't be easier. First, find the perfect transition for your project and click download. Once downloaded, extract the file and you'll see that the transition is a MoGurt file, which stands for Motion Graphics Template. To import your MoGurt file into Premiere, go to the Graphics Templates panel. Depending on your workspace, it could be in a variety of different places. On the editing workspace, it's here in the lower left, but if you can't see it, go to Window, Graphics Templates. Once that's open, click the Install Motion Graphics Template icon, navigate to the MoGurt file, and press Open. Now your transition template has been added into Premiere Pro. You can find hundreds of Premiere Pro transition templates on Storyblocks, including glitch transitions, lens flares, comic style effects, and more. Also, with the Storyblocks plugin for Adobe Creative Cloud, you can bring all of these assets directly into Premiere Pro, which makes the importing process for Mogurts even simpler. And there you have it, the basics of adding transitions in Premiere Pro. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for future tutorials you'd like to see us cover, leave them in the comments below. Then head over to storyblocks.com to check out a wide range of customizable Premiere Pro transitions, royalty-free 4K footage, music, and more.